Hello students, in our last class we were dealing with the method of preparation of alkyl halides. No, this was the chemical equation involved. Alcohol that reacts with halogen acid, they undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction and alkyl halide is our desired product. Today we will discuss some chemical reactions which involve rearrangement. The SN1 reaction of alcohols with halogen acids often involve rearrangement whenever the initially formed carbocation can be changed into relatively more stable carbocation intermediate, and generally these rearrangement occurs through 1,2 hydride set or 1,2 alkyl set. We can explain it by taking one suitable example. Let us consider one alcohol molecule . This is your alcohol substrate. I've considered 3-methylbutyl-2-ol. When this alcohol then be treated with one of the halogen acid, let's consider HBr. What have we done? In this kind of reactions, first of all, this alcohol gets protonated. In order to increase the leaving ability of this leaving group, this is your leaving group. This is to be substituted by the halide ion. So first of all, it gets protonated. Then you will get the protonated alcohol first. This is our protonated alcohol. Here Br minus that can be presented here. Next, after protonation, this leaving group that gets eliminated. This is in accordance with SN1 mechanism. Okay. After the release of the leaving group, water molecule, you will get your carbocation intermediate. This is the carbocation intermediate here. Next, what is expected to happen? This nucleophile that should attack this carbocation, but here this carbocation intermediate, it can be rearranged into another stable carbocation species. This can be converted into another more stable carbocation species. Let me write the stable carbocation which would be formed here first. Try to understand this stage. In the previous carbocation, the positive charge was over the secondary carbon. This is the secondary carbocation. Just adjacent to this carbon, one tertiary carbon is present which contains one hydrogen. When this hydrogen that will be migrated in the form of hydride ion to the previous carbon, then the positive charge will appear over this carbon, tertiary carbon. It means we will get a tertiary carbocation. And what have we done? Tertiary carbocation is more stable as compared to secondary carbocation. So this is the rearrangement step. These two species, they are similar with respect to the number of hydrogen atoms, the number of carbon atoms, right? Only a migration of hydride ion has been taken place, and this is called 1,2 hydride shift. 1,2 hydride shift. Here 1,2 that refers to the adjacent carbon atoms. Okay, hydride ion that has been shifted from one carbon to the another carbon, resulting in the formation of this stable carbocation. Next, the last step will happen. The nucleophile Br minus was the nucleophile. This Br minus, it is the nucleophile that will attack this carbon center, giving rise to the formation of the final product. CS3 here, Br bonded CH2 CS3. This is our final product. Okay. So the deviation in the reaction, that is simply due to this rearrangement steps. We need to think about these rearrangement steps. Whenever the initially formed carbocation, that can be converted into a more stable carbocation. Tertiary carbocation, benzylic carbocation, allylic carbocation. If these kind of carbocation stresses can be formed, if the chances of formation of these kind of carbocation be there, then we need to think about the rearrangement steps. Okay. Similarly, another example can be considered here. This is another alcohol molecule, neopentyl alcohol. When this is treated with one halogen acid, let us consider HF. Similar to the previous steps, first of all, protonation will occur. Protonation, after protonation, you will get the protonated alcohol. This is your protonated alcohol. I minus, that has been mentioned here. This is going to be the nucleophile. After the protonation, this leaving group that will be eliminated out, resulting in the formation of a carbocation intermediate. This is your carbocation. Here, water molecule will be eliminated out. This is in accordance with SN1 mechanism. I need to specify the nucleophile side by side. This carbocation, now it can be rearranged into more stable carbocation again. This is the primary carbocation. And just adjacent to it, one quaternary carbon atom is there. Out of these three methyl groups, when any of the methyl group that will be migrated to this carbon containing positive charge, then in the next carbocation stresses, positive charge will appear over this tertiary carbon atom. What have I told? When any of these methyl group that will be shifted, that will be migrated to the carbon containing positive charge, let us consider the migration of this methyl group. Then what would be your carbocation? CH3, a positive charge will appear here because the methyl group which was present here, that has been shifted to CH2CH3. The methyl group here which was present here, that has been migrated. Okay, this is a tertiary carbocation. It has primary carbocation. However, this is tertiary carbocation. This is more stable carbocation. More stable carbocation. And due to higher stability of this resulting carbocation, this rearrangement step will occur smoothly. This is called 1,2-methyl shift. 1,2-methyl shift. Because a methyl group that has been shifted. Here, hydride ion was shifted. Here, methyl group that has been shifted. For that reason, this is called 1,2-methyl shift. As a result of 1,2-methyl shift, we have got this stable carbocation. And similar to the previous steps, in the last step, the nucleophile I minus that will attack this carbon. Okay? So, you will get your final product CH3, CCH3, CH2, CH3, and I would be here. This is your final product. 2-iodo-2-methyl-butyl. Okay? So, this is the rearrangement, and these are certain examples which involve the rearrangement. Let me tell you once again, we need to think about the rearrangement steps whenever the alcohol undergoes SN1 reaction with halogen acid, and if the initially formed carbocation, it can be converted into more stable carbocation like tertiary carbocation, allylic carbocation, benzylic carbocation. Okay? and generally these rearrangement occurs through 1,2-hydride set or 1,2-alkyl set.